Eoghan Corry, editor of Travel Extra, has more on this now. Eoghan, how many passengers being disrupted?
Well, there'll be about 6,000. I mean, we've one sailing seriously disrupted already in both directions. We've an upcoming weekend and the weekend after. Back in action June 16. Not clear how much of the how many bookings there are on the ship, but it is pretty large. It's got 2,415 passenger and 600 vehicle capacity. Not peak season, but very close to it. Big problem for the passengers and a big problem for the ferry company.
So what do you do if you're booked on one of those sailings?
You're going to be contacted by the ferry company, as in these situations. Ferry companies aren't built to get all their passengers contacting the same time. A big problem with Brittany is that their Britain to Spain sailings are also. So they say they will contact people who are due to sail first. They will offer them a refund. They will offer them an alternative, and the alternative will be a sailing from Cork to Roscoff. The big problem there is that the vessel they're bringing in to services has got only one-third the capacity that the Pont Eoghan has. So not everybody's going to get on board. They're also offering land bridge. You drive, get to Rosslare through England and come down on one of the Brittany ferry sailings. The most likely one is Plymouth to Roscoff. They also have a pool to Cherbourg sailing, and you can have a refund. But it's going to take a little bit of while for the dust to clear, and Brittany are under siege. The travel agents have been contacting them, wanting to know what's happening, and the channels of communications are not working very well, to say the least.
And this comes after Irish Ferries had problems last year, we know. Very difficult for passengers to find a reliable service that they can book and be sure it's going to run.
Well, with the airline industry, there are usually spare planes sitting around. There aren't spare ferries sitting around. So the impact on the recovery from it and the recovery time from it can be quite difficult. The passenger rights and the consumer rights in aviation is far more involved. The famous EU 261 that people, listeners, will be familiar with. A lot of listeners wouldn't even know where to start bringing a ferry complaint. The authority is the National Transportation Authority, and Irish Ferries are disputing the findings that arose out of last summer. It's consumer compensation regime is quite similar to aviation, but as I say, not as well evolved, and the relationship between ferry companies and the authorities not as well evolved either.
Eoghan Corry, editor of Travel Extra, thank you for bringing us that on Brittany Ferries.